As to where his sound came from, BB has always said he was influenced by steel guitar and the bottleneck blues of his cousin, Booker White.
I've got stupid fingers. I never could make mine. I couldn't do any of that. I'm no good at using my hand this way. But I take it and trill it like this. And my old ears said, oh, that sound a little bit like them.
Kick it off, somebody.
In 1956, BB made 342 appearances in 366 days, plus three separate recording sessions. In those days, he was playing to mostly black audiences. Nowadays, they're mostly white males from the baby boomer generation, a legacy of the remarkable turnaround in the fortune of the blues, which saw BB's audience change from 95% black in 1963 to 95% white in 1968.
You have really spent your whole life on the road, haven't you? I mean, you're a nomad, really.
Well, yes, but I've had to. Blues hasn't been a popular music in America. And in fact, it seemed like white America didn't even know about blues, only little corners here, corners there. But when the Rolling Stones, the Who, oh, the Cream, and I can name you quite a few groups that came over here after the Beatles, oh boy, it opened up then.
Well, since my baby left me, well, I found a new place to dwell. Well, it's down at the end of Lone Street.
Back in the days when BB was still on the radio in Memphis, his music caught the imagination of a young white boy who could often be found hanging around the Beale Street music joints. At the age of 18, that same boy, Elvis Aaron Presley, turned up here at Sun Studios to cut a record for his mother's birthday. Impressed by what he heard, the studio's owner, Sam Phillips, asked Elvis to return for an audition, partnering him with local musicians, Bill Black on bass and Scotty Moore on lead guitar. It was a chance encounter that has defined modern music. They seem to just happen in this part of the world.
All right, guys, this is it. It's pretty small, isn't it? But a lot of big things happened in this little space. And on July 5th, 1954, Elvis stood right here on this X.
Elvis Presley, what kind of name is that? You know, it was a really strange name for that period of time.
Elvis had a great band. Scotty Moore played guitar right where you are, guys, on that X.
And here's Scotty on the Milton Berle Show in 1956. Elvis wasn't the only star discovered by Sam Phillips that night.
Met Sam Phillips at Sun Records. He said, I'd like to see what the boy sounds like with a little music behind him. So it was on tape. See, tape was very, very fresh in 1954. So we went down there on Monday night, and that's where all hell broke loose.
Real Hot Blue coming through WHBQ and Hotel Chisca.
The resulting track was That's All Right Mama, and two nights later it all kicked off on the radio show of Memphis DJ Dewey Phillips. He played it 14 times in 3 hours. The requests kept coming, and Elvis got a recording contract.
Elvis is playing rhythm, and I'm playing the lead on it. But we're actually both playing rhythm for the most part. It was an audition. See, you had more liberties on an audition than you would if you was actually in there doing a record session to begin with. You could experiment, do whatever you wanted to.
Well, that's all right, Mama.
And it was something different from day one. Bill said, well, hope we don't get run out of town, you know, something like that.
The rest is pop history. Far from being run out of town, Elvis became a star, and the sound of Scotty Moore's guitar cast a spell over a generation.
I never felt like I had a style. I just put in what I could, what little I knew, and went from there.
Guitar-based rock and roll has gone on to dominate popular music in a way those involved on that night in July could hardly have imagined. And Scotty Moore's explanation is more than a little enigmatic.
Have you ever heard about the Mojo Triangle? Well, I thought everybody in the world knew about the Mojo Triangle. All the music that comes from New Orleans to Memphis, up through Clarksville and Mississippi, up to Memphis, up to Nashville, and back to New Orleans. That's the Mojo Triangle. And you look in history books and see how many artists and how much music come out of that area. And don't ask me why, I don't know. Bunch of cotton pickers, I'll tell you that.
Elvis's particular fusion of blues and country seemed to spring from the very soil of Memphis. But over on the West Coast, things were different. Guitar music was dominated by the clean-picking style of Merle Travis. Veteran of 1,000 cowboy radio spots and Hollywood shorts known as soundies. Merle was born in Kentucky, but California was where the work was and where the guitar was about to take its next leap forward. When the guitar took on a solid body and was reinvented for the modern world. And this is the man who did it. Leo Fender, a radio repairman from California, did more to spread the gospel of the electric guitar than any individual before or since. But the man whose name is forever linked with the electric guitar never actually learned to play himself. He started tinkering with radios as a boy and went on to build amplifiers in his small factory in Fullerton, California. This Super 8 footage from the late 50s was only recently discovered and has never been shown outside the Fender boardroom. The Fender Telecaster, a single slab of wood with holes cut for the electronics and a bolt-on neck, was made for easy assembly. It was revolutionary, and together with a Fender amp, produced a clean sound, which they were able to advertise as the very latest thing. And it got its name from another modern phenomenon that seemed to be taking over the world. Television. It's been in continuous production since 1950. One of the most popular guitars ever.
That much, so it's a much more lighter spot.
So who would be playing that then, basically?
Most of the country records are all played on it. People like the classic exponents of the Telecaster would be James Burton, who played on the Ricky Nelson records in the 50s, and he played for Elvis in the 1970s. Steve Cropper from Booker T and the MGs. A lot of the soul guitarists like the Telecaster. In a mix on a record, it doesn't take up so much space. It's a thinner sounding instrument. If you don't want loads of distortion on it and a cleaner, more twangy sound, Telecaster is a good basic guitar.
Provoked by the success of the Fender Telecaster, the competition had to respond. The more traditional Gibson Company, maker of all those finely crafted archtop and jazz guitars, was stung into action. The guitar wars had begun. Gibson were now ready to reconsider the solid body experiments that Les Paul started back in the early 40s. And this is the infamous Log. So what did they make of the Log in 1941?
They looked at it and laughed like hell. They thought it was awful. Right? Gibson thought it was awful. Everybody thought it was terrible.
Now, there's one more thing to add to that.
Les had another trick up his sleeve.
Les being sort of a unique individual and having a good sense of humor, he made these so that you could sort of imagine it as an actual guitar.
They said, you were the joke of Gibson for 10 years.
So they thought you were nuts, really?
Yeah, they thought I was a little strange.
Well, strange or not, Gibson realized they were missing out on a potentially huge market. They needed to catch up with Fender and make a solid body guitar of their own. It would be called the Les Paul.
So it all starts with the wood, right? Every great guitar has to be made from great wood. The secret of a Les Paul, which is our flagship model, is a combination of mahogany and maple woods. And these are pieces of mahogany that'll be married with a maple cap and then cut into the shape of a guitar. But these are the two basic elements of a Les Paul guitar that create the sustain and the power that you associate with a Gibson Les Paul.
These are very, very sought after collectibles, with this particular one being $130,000. So people like these.
Do you play all, do you actually play all these, or?
Well, I play them and I cherish them. Mm-hmm. This is the top of the heap right here. There's no question about it. Look at the flame on that one.
Yes.
Look, it's quite unbelievable. This one is just, it's perfect. 1959.
Here is a Gibson Les Paul from 1958. Same kind of thing. The 58s and 59s seem to be the ones that everybody's after.
You can listen.
How much is this?
Just listen for a minute. Sustain. Listen to it.
I'm not hearing anything.
You would, though, if it were playing, because it really, it's famous for its sustain. I mean, you can just hold it.
Well, so you'd have to pull.
You can go and have a bite. No, you'd still be hearing that one.
Yeah.
And I actually had to wait a long time to find the right Les Paul. I didn't realize just how great these late 50s Gibsons actually were until I played them.
There has been some dispute as to just how involved Les was in all this.
He did not convince Gibson to make a solid body guitar. Gibson already knew they darn well had to do that. And for that matter, Les did not design the guitar from the ground up, nor did he invent the electric guitar or the solid body guitar. That had been done before.
But there's no doubting his advertising value at the time. Between 1950 and 1954, he and Mary had 16 top 10 hits.
It's a scarecrow for the garden. I still have to stuff the sleeves. Would you like to do a song?
Well, all right.
We met, we kissed.
Remember, between 1953 and 1960, Mary and I were on five times a day, five times a week, on radio and television. The electric guitar was being exposed greatly.
My days are years. Won't you please come back?
No matter what you play on the guitar, electric, acoustic, no matter what you do to the guitar, the person on the other end doesn't say it's an electric guitar, it's acoustical guitar. She says, I love that fellow playing that guitar.
So there's something about the instrument and the person together.
That's right.
And the sound that's made. It's not just the instrument. It's
no.
The person who
it's
plays
the marriage. When I play the guitar, I find that if I hit the note here, it's different than hitting it here, striking the note differently.